These songs have been helpful to many people over the years. They're designed to generate discussion, and I hope you enjoy them. I want to talk about metaphors for a minute. These songs are like little movies or paintings that bring up real-life issues such as incest, sexual orientation, masturbation, and fidelity. And in doing so, they act as metaphors for us to make some clear connections about our own real-life struggles. Many of us have been injured, and we have automatic defenses that protect us from looking directly into our painful places, even though these old wounds drive much of our daily behavior. Using a metaphor like one of these songs provides a safe, non-threatening experience so we can understand how these issues play out in our lives. We can develop skills and strategies to bring ourselves back into balance and begin to heal. I hope you sing along and laugh with these songs. The humor is never at anyone's expense, and if some painful emotions surface, hey, it's a wonderful chance to feel and release them and explore why they've been hidden. 1. Baby Needs a Parent is a song for single parents. Single parenting can be overwhelming and lonely at times, but it can also be less complicated when you don't have to deal with the other parent. Some single parents buy things for their children to compensate for the loss of the other parent, but kids don't need more stuff. They need a well-adjusted adult in their life who loves them and can model a full range of healthy emotions. Some single-parent homes have produced some very well-balanced children, including homes with gay and lesbian parents. Children who grow up in such a home do not automatically become homosexual themselves because, as these special parents point out, gee, we grew up with heterosexual parents. That didn't influence our sexual orientation. 2. It's Only a Wee Wee is about sex role conditioning. What's the first question we ask when a baby's born? Is it a boy or a girl? It starts right away. Adults make much more of a big deal about sex than kids do, so this song's really to get adults thinking about our gender stereotypes. It's obvious that the range of human sexual behavior, identity, and orientation is not limited by our genitalia. 3. Let the Woman in You Come Through addresses the fact that many men feel a need to appear tough or macho to avoid teasing or ridicule. We know that if a boy cries or shows any gentleness, he risks being called a sissy. Why should acting like someone's sister be taken as the worst kind of insult? Male fear and negativity about women in our culture doesn't make much sense. Our bodies make both estrogen and androgen, and gentle, nurturing behaviors are exhibited by both genders, especially when they're encouraged. 4. Buddies is about having close friends to talk to as a major part of our safety net during difficult times. It's essential to have a family of choice to support us. This is a song for buddies we love, regardless of their gender. If you're bothered by the reference to alcohol in the line, "You're a mug of cold beer," change it to, "God, I wish you were here." Some of us medicate with alcohol, while others preoccupy ourselves with relationship difficulties. 5. The humor of Hopelessly Heterosexual comes out of the heterosexual man's homophobia clashing with his sexual curiosity, not from any ridicule or negativity. Gay men and lesbians in our culture face incredible rejection because our society is so hopelessly heterosexual. This song's good for discussions on heterosexism and homophobia, to friendship, male bonding, and the origins of our sexuality. There are things about ourselves that we don't choose, things we discover as we go on living. Our sexual orientation is one of them. Why would a 12-year-old boy choose to be gay when he knows he'll be shunned by his straight friends? The marvelous process of exploring and discovering our sexuality is severely squashed by the traditional sex role expectations in our culture. 6. My Secret addresses closed-mindedness. It's about acting out sexually, something we all do to some degree or another. Some people act out very secretly. When we have secrets and feel the need to hide what we're doing, it's usually because we're ashamed. And shame is about who we are, and there's nothing wrong with who we are. We're each on our own path with our own obstacles and our own work to do. People who cross-dress compulsively or who spread jam on their body or who sexualize every situation are driven by the same avoidance of painful feelings as people who use less secret medicators like alcohol or work. 7. The Country and Western Transylvania Love Song is about a teenage werewolf who has an uncontrollable urge to roam. It covers dating, flirting, the excitement and danger of getting caught in a forbidden embrace, fighting, and the emotional high drama that happens when we create a crisis. Bob's two-timing is not uncommon dating behavior. And when Hetty decides to shoot him with a silver bullet for his own good, claiming it's because she loves him, it's an example of the all-or-nothing, black-and-white thinking exhibited by many adult children of alcoholics. This is romance addiction at its finest. 8. But I'm only doing it for you, is always a questionable statement. Male behavior is often focused on getting female approval. So when men perform and women don't respond appropriately, men get hurt and angry and blame. The line, "So I only hit you once," generates laughter from an audience, but it's always an uncomfortable laugh. We laugh because it's unexpected and because there's such a huge flaw in the singer's logic, but we know that domestic violence is a very serious problem. In this country, there's a rape every 9 minutes and a beating every 30 seconds. Unfortunately, if we're not the ones doing it and not the ones it's happening to, we remain silent. 9. I hope you understand, dear, is about breaking off an affair with a laptop. Some of us use work to avoid painful feelings. We medicate by working compulsively and accomplishing things, even though we may be dying inside from loneliness. We feel that if we can just get enough control of the world around us, we can make everything work out just right. Well, obsessive romance and falling in love are powerful medicators, and we can actually have an affair with our work to avoid facing some of the painful realities of our relationships at home. 10. Man Oh Man I Can is a silly song, but it's great for bringing up issues about objectification of women, communication difficulties, fear of closeness, blaming, masturbation, jealousy, and parental criticism. Having a plastic or wooden significant other certainly makes it clear who's in charge of the relationship, doesn't it? Finding a partner who doesn't mind if we're always in control and keeping our focus on sex and love and romance helps us avoid feeling lonely, but it doesn't solve our problems. We find ourselves stuck in a relationship where we're merely existing, not really living. 11. Lists is about falling in love and becoming compulsive and obsessive about another person. Falling in love is an altered state of mind, not unlike being drugged. It may be helpful to ask ourselves if we are growing in love with someone, which implies all of the difficult parts of building a relationship that has emotional safety as well as caring and sexual intimacy. Compulsive list making can bring a loving relationship to its knees. When we feel we must follow a list and complete everything, we may have lost sight of why the list was made in the first place. 12. When you ask me first chronicles a man's difficulty with relinquishing control in the bedroom. Being on the receiving end of someone else's passion can be a humbling and upsetting experience, but hey, if someone wants to make love with us, we must be desirable, right? This song's good for discussing expectations, control, and individual preferences.